Yeah, I don't know what will happen in next year. I think there will be a big rebuild, and I'm kind of hyped. I'm actually super hyped for next year and my journey.
Hey guys, this is Ashley Kang of Horizon Esports. This interview has been brought to you by Sickle Lab, and I'm joined by Nomenz, the mid laner of Unicorns of Love, after they played the final game, their game, at 2021 World Championship. Hey, Nomenz, thank you so much for joining me for this interview. It must be a really tiring day, but how are you feeling?
Yeah, it was a hard day. Thanks for the invite. I'm happy to be here.
And so many things have happened today, and I really want to look back to the C9 game. I will be honest, because C9 was undefeated and UOL didn't have a good match score, many people didn't trust UOL to be able to beat that C9, but can you run me through the victory, maybe from the draft, perhaps?
Oh, I can start even from morning.
Like, oh, yeah, sure.
All of the players wanted to win today, because if you win C9, we have a tiebreak, and if you have a tiebreak, we still have a chance to make it to main stage. We didn't surrender, basically. And draft idea, like sign flex with Sienna, it's something from Santos. He prepared it, I think, 2 years ago, but he couldn't ever play it.
Hmm.
And he said, okay, like, doesn't matter if we will have a good draft, we just should do it. Like flex sign. And I think it worked out really well, because he picked Gangplank into sign, which is like a really good matchup for GP. But then we counterpicked GP with Camille, and they were probably super surprised because of it. But yeah, after we win C9, I don't know. I think we should win against Beyond, but somehow we lost the game.
What do you think happened? So going back to the draft once more, against Beyond, I think Beyond's Tahm Kench had a huge impact on how the game was played, perhaps. Would you agree with this statement? Because it was a surprise pick, and surprise picks are always more difficult to handle.
I think that happened because first Draven was strong and Tahm Kench can peel him with his ultimate, right? Same as like old Tahm Kench was doing to ADC. But I think why Tahm Kench gets strong is because our boys dive him on top and both died. That was like so bad for Jace lane. Then they could dive. Yeah. Then they can dive Jace like every lane, every wave, whenever they want. So yeah, Tahm Kench got out of control. Draven is fed, so Tahm Kench can peel Draven, and then he built this item that reduces my damage on him, and I can't do anything to him as well. So yeah, Tahm Kench was strong this game.
Did you feel a bit of pressure, because I realized that you were picking Orianna, and Orianna was the only source of AP damage in the team, and other AD champions in your team like Jace simply could not go through Tahm Kench when he was like frontlining?
Yeah, it was so hard to find a good fight, because they have Rakan, and Rakan have a Cloud Soul, so when he press ult, he's so fast. And hard to play for me team fights, but if somehow I can survive Rakan engage, then I think we're gonna win the fight, because my champion like Ariana is so good into Draven Ryze, but Rakan was the biggest thing for me in team fights. It was so hard to play team fights because of Rakan and Cloud Soul.
What is your overall takeaway for the day? Are you like maybe a bit sad that your journey in 2020 Worlds can continue, or maybe you're proud that you took down Cloud9? Which way would it be?
Oh yeah, I'm really proud that we could beat C9, but for sure we should beat Beyond after we beat C9, but yeah, somehow we failed. I don't know what will happen in next year. I think there will be a big rebuild, and I'm kind of hyped. I'm actually super hyped for next year and my journey. Right now, I will just chill a bit and keep playing solo queue and improving.
I'm glad that you took it as a positive sentiment, because we've been watching this UOL for so many years, and I know that UOL also has a lot of supporter. And every year, they have a really strong performance in the first stage, but maybe come just short of making it to the group stage.
Oh, MSI was a disaster. MSI was just
okay, maybe last year.
Yeah, last year we did good. We had a good results. Yeah, but we couldn't find it was said that we couldn't find a win in main stage, like at least on NA team. But Chovy and Knight was too strong for me last year.
Because you mention it, can I very carefully ask, What makes you excited for next year?
I'm not sure if I can say it
okay.
yet because yeah. of the contract,
mm-hmm.
but I'm really excited for my journey. Let's go like this.
Okay. Yeah. And we will be excited for you and we will look forward to your journey. Thank you so much for this interview, Nomans. Do you have any message to the fans that have watched your journey in 2021 Worlds and throughout CIS and will continue to be excited for your journey next year and maybe more years?
I'm super sorry for this year, like especially MSI and Worlds. We lost in a bad way, like we didn't do much and just lose the game. It probably felt super bad for fans to watch these games. And I'm sorry for that. We were not strong enough to pull out a good game. If you want, guys, you can hate me or like hate others, yeah, but it's fine. It's fine.
Do you have anything you want to say to your teammates, maybe, then?
Oh, teammates?
Yeah.
I really like Anna Boss and Santos. Nasik Boss and Santos, I like them a lot. But I want to say something to Arganov. Maybe he'll hear it. I think Arganov is a really good player, but he's just too young for this team. I think he'll keep improving, and one day he'll be one of the best Russian ADC ever. And he should not tilt himself because of bad games. That's what he usually do. Like, I think this is not productive. Yeah, that's all what I wanted to say.
We'll also look forward to his journey. And again, Nomans, I'll see you next year. And I'll see you in a bigger stage. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.